Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nature, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity. Here I give the exposition of the Gnostic Gospel of St. Thomas, which is very original and very spiritual. So here is the exposition of Logos 106 to 12. Jesus says, "Cursed are they, the Pharisees, because they are like a dog which has lain in the cattle manger for the sake of greed and mammon, but will neither eat the food understand the scriptures, not allow the oxen to eat it. They would not allow others to understand the gospel either. Oxen stands for hard-working secular people who do not cheat others." Jesus says, "Blessed is the man who knows where the robbers are going to enter, so that he watches. He gathers his strength and girds his loins before they enter. Gospel being light, a person of light knows where the thieves may enter his house," that means physical body. "So he keeps a watch over his affairs and does not allow the hypocrites to take him for a ride. They said to him, 'Come, let us pray and fast today.' Jesus says, 'What then is the sin that I have committed? You fast, you know, remember that Saul fasted for 4 days to repent for the killings he did in ignorance. Or in what have I been at fault, or what wrong have I done that you want me to pray? If you do things wrong, then you repent and sincerely pray to behave yourself in future. But when the bridegroom comes out of the bridal chamber, then they must fast and pray." Now the Jesus, he was the light, and they were, all the laborers were under the care of Christ Jesus. That means they are in light. So they don't need to pray because God is omniscient. When you are in the light of God, then you do not need to fast or pray, as God is omniscient. Twice born people do not waste their precious time at lengthy prayers, but ponder over his word through intuition or logical reasoning." You see, in churches, these clerics praying, which will last for 5 minutes or so, and they mention everything and keep on saying Amen, Amen, Amen. And there's no good to pray like those, as if the God doesn't know the matters of your heart. Prayer does work for the once born people, as Saint Peter prayed and he was set free from the jail. Jesus says, "He who knows Father, God and Mother, Holy Spirit, shall he be called by the once born people in anger a bastard." So people, you know, who are once born, they do not understand the word of God, and when you tell them the things of God which are hanging upside down to the material word, then they call you a son of a harlot or a bastard. "Many people from the Punjab shout abuses at me and write a language which is coming from bastards. People who replace their tribal identity or surnames with religious common names such as Singh become bastards of their own choice and ignorance. Always identify yourself with your family surname, as the bastards born of the prostitutes have no known tribal surnames. Jesus says, when you make the two one, when you are of your tribal father and do not display your tribal ego, then only you come to know your father in spirit, and you make the two into one by loving and serving people without any tribal biases or the person is black, brown or white. You will become sons of man, would display salt of the earth as Abraham did in humanity. And if you say, mountain move, it will move, as Christ Jesus made the wind to calm down during the tempest. Jesus says, the royal kingdom of God is like a shepherd who has 100 sheep. 100 sheep stand for gods and goddesses that people used to worship. Say, they call them ilah, the tribal gods. People worship at Kabah, the temple of Adam. One of them, that is God, without which the tribal gods and goddesses are useless and dead, the biggest went astray. So the man, he left the 99 others sheep and looked for this single sheep until he found it. That means God is not lying on a platter as the gods and goddesses are, but you have to be sensible enough to seek him. This is like finding the narrow road that leads you to salvation. After taking this trouble, he said to the sheep, I love you more than the 99 others. That means this God, which is the life of everything, is the essence of our life, and without him we are dead. So that's why we should love God with all our heart and might. You have to make efforts yourself to know God and not go by hearsay that God is here and there, locked up in the temples or churches. Jesus says, he who drinks from my mouth will become like me. As for me, I will become what he is, and what is hidden will be revealed to him. Christ Jesus trained his laborers so well that if a stranger came, he would not know which of them is the real Christ Jesus. Thus they were trained workers, and the temple priests have to hire an insider, Judas Iscariot, to pinpoint the real Christ Jesus. I have explained this in a separate video. So in Christ Jesus, you have to be sensible, and God is not lying on a platter, as you can see with your two naked eyes, as you see the statues of gods and goddesses. So in the churches, people make a statue of Christ Jesus and make him dead. So Christ Jesus is living in his word, and you have to be sensible enough to understand gospel, and gospel is as is understood and preached on a basis of logical reasoning. So if you are capable of logical reasoning, then you will find the royal kingdom of God. So this narrow road that leads to salvation is not blind people can't find it. You need to have the third eye of logical reasoning. So once you get that third eye for logical reasoning, then only you can find the narrow gate to narrow road that leads to the royal kingdom of God or to salvation. So be living, and always think and ponder over thing. When you ponder over thing, that God will give you the answer. Best thing is do it early morning when your brain is fresh. And God bless you. Let's go to the next 10-5.